Union General Ambrose Burnside, a well-intentioned officer, had succeeded the too cautious McClellan as commander of the Army of the Potomac. Burnside quickly moved his forces to Fredericksburg in an attempt to cross the Rappahannock River, drive past Lee, and make for Richmond. Failure of pontoon bridges to arrive promptly crippled the effort and enabled Lee to take a strong position on high ground behind the town. 13 times Burnside attacked. 13 times the blue columns. In the end, the Union Army suffered 12,600 dead bodies, with not a single Billy Yank coming within 50 yards of the main Confederate line. Lee's losses were fewer than 5,000 men. In the cold weeks thereafter, Union soldiers were locked in camp and lacking in everything. Sickness, poor food, inadequate medical care, sagging morale, and steady desertion convulsed the Union Army. One officer called the run of 1862-63 the Valley Forge of the Civil War.
General Lieutenant on the west side. still have to do a lot of things. But no more job plan at the end of one month.
Doctor knows about as much as a 10-year-old boy.
Edward W. Prevent, Union Soldier from Arizona.
About 100 hospital tents are on the grounds now, and they all seem thrilled to be patient soldiers. Hundreds more are in great. surgeons and their assistants in front of the tents under the guard. Private Robert Knox Sneddon had battled the Chickahominy.
We invariably used chloroform, and we never met with the least accident, or even in between wounds. Felix Rolling, Louisiana Hospital.
Ghastly were the numbers of amputated limbs found, great numbers, in several places of the town. Edward I. Heineken, resident of Fredericksburg.
We operated an old bloodstained and often pus-stained coat, the veteran of 100 fights. We operated with clean hands in a social sense, but they were undisinfected.
Thank you.
was only 18 years old. Most of them are about that age. Mere boys. He was an only son. He wounded in the chest and lungs. Doctors could do nothing for him. I held his hand, wiped his forehead and cheeks while he struggled for breath. I told him, God would welcome him to eternal life. Geniuses. I always stood caring.